This is Matt Allen, founder and owner of Adjuster TV Plus. He's found major success in the small niche of independent insurance adjuster training. In this conversation, we'll learn his path from monetization beginner to membership owner and how even in a small niche, Adjuster TV Plus is thriving with over 500 members. Matt has some great advice for creators who want to monetize their knowledge, so let's get into it.
So when you started the YouTube channel 6 years ago, when did you start Adjuster TV Plus?
I think I have had Adjuster TV Plus, this is the third year, I want to say.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure.
So
I think I started
then,
in like 2020.
You had the YouTube channel for 3 years. How did you validate that there would be demand for the paid membership version? Was it people reaching out to you in the comments or emails? Like, what was it that prompted you to say, yeah, I think that there is a space for me to have a paid version of this?
I think that I was getting, so a lot of my YouTube content necessarily is kind of top of funnel sort of thing, right? There's a lot of like how to change careers after the age of 50, because a lot of my audience is that, you know, it's awareness. But I was getting a lot of requests for, hey, I don't know how to do this one thing, for how-to video, like specific detailed how-to videos. And one of the things that I do that I think separates me from the very small handful of other people that are in my little niche is that I put a lot of effort into partnering with industry providers, the companies that hire us, the companies that train us. And so I had kind of hooked up with a guy who has like sort of the premier like in-person hands-on insurance adjusting school, and we decided to do a series of videos, and I said there's no way in the world I'm giving that away for free. It was all, you know, all the hands-on stuff, all the how-to stuff that I was getting questions on. I was like, well, let's put this behind a paywall and see what happens. It was a little bit of kind of a cart before the horse, and I freely admit that one of my biggest mistakes, and this is a piece of advice I would give to anybody starting a YouTube channel or a Uscreen channel, is to do your market research first. Like, do a lot of it. Your you know, ICA calls, your ideal customer avatar calls, you know, when you start building an audience, really, really, really find out where those people are at and where they're finding you, because it's not, you can have some influence on where that line, those lines cross, but there's like a main, there's a spot where they cross, and you've lost them after this and you don't have them before that. To be perfectly transparent, I didn't do a whole lot of ICA, you know, like marketing research before I kind of leapt into the Uscreen thing. I just thought it would be super duper cool, and I figured, well, if I can start generating income with it, then that'll allow me to make more higher production value videos for that platform, which is what I want to personally do. That's like my favorite thing. So, confession.
What was the first way that you monetized video content after starting Adjuster TV?
Yeah, so good question. The very first thing I did, I had sort of the sort of genesis of the whole Adjuster TV thing was something, basically ebook or a guide that I had written several years before when I was working on Hurricane Katrina. I was seeing a lot of people wash out and get kicked off that storm and basically just like spinning out. I was like, well, this is not that hard of a job. Let me figure out a way, like a step-by-step blueprint for them. That kind of became the first thing that I sold, and I was shocked. I think it was within 6 months of when I started the channel, I was building up, you know, the social media stuff and YouTube, and then I had a sale, sold this ebook, and I think I made like $6,000 in a weekend. And I was like,
wow.
The things kept popping up on my phone, and I was selling it for like $30. So it freaked me out a little bit because I felt like I was stealing, because it was, you know what I mean? Obviously, you know, a lot of people bought the book, they read it, I got a lot of good feedback from it, and I developed, you know, after that, I developed that into like a video course, a video training that expanded on that content. And that was the next thing that I sold, which did even better than that first thing. And then then it was Uscreen. And
one of the things I noticed in looking through your site was that your pricing for Adjuster TV Plus is actually higher than I see in a lot of others, mostly because I'm thinking of fitness where the bar is typically set a little bit lower. So I'm curious, how did you decide what your price point was going to be? Like, what were the factors that went into that? And then how has that performed for you?
Yeah, the pricing was, I settled on the pricing. I was talking to everybody and anybody who would listen who I thought could have, you know, provide some insight into, you know, where I should set the price. And I think the first pricing was $29 or $29. And that seemed to do pretty well. And I think that there was sort of a moving target, the line where, you know, what value are they getting out of my content and what are they willing to pay for it? That's been, I don't raise the price. I only raised the price once since I started my channel. And again, the last time I did it, I was like, hey, listen, we're getting ready to raise the price. And so I had like 2 or 3 weeks worth of promotional, just putting ads and, you know, posts and whatever else up. And it drove a huge amount of traffic, which was again, like I said, was really great. So I sometimes wonder, well, you know, what if I'd made it $9.99 a month, you know, or $19.99 a month? Would have a lot more subscribers in there? Which, you know, again, I mean, there's pros and cons certainly to this kind of thing. Well, you might initially generate less income, but you might have more subscribers. And then what would that do to your churn? Would they be higher quality or lower quality, you know, customers? Would they stay in longer than 3.5 months, you know, which is kind of my average. I think that people stay in there for retention. So I'm okay at math, but all those factors together. So I was like, you know what, $29, that's what it's going to be. And I'm just going to try to make it more valuable than that. And I have people tell me all the time, well, you're not charging enough for that. And I'm like, well, you know, I have subscribers that have been members since I launched it, and some of them have paid more than $1,000, you know, in subscription, you know, fees over that time, and they just keep it. They're like, I'm never quitting it. Other people, you know, occasionally get an email, you know, from those cranky people out there, but that's very small minority of people.
And how many members do you have these days?
I think there's 500. I want to say somewhere between 450. 550, something like that. I did try to use Uscreen as a platform for a course, like that I sold as a one-off, and they got free memberships as part of that. So there's some of that number is people that got a free membership.
Tell me about your podcast. How does that play a role in your business?
Yeah, so the podcast is generally an audio version of some of the longer form, like interviews that I do, or Q&As or long form discussions I might have with another host or myself. I kind of put those out there sort of as to sort of see how it would work. I know that adjusters are, because we're catastrophe adjusters, and you know the catastrophe doesn't always happen in our backyard, we're traveling a lot. So a lot of hotel, a lot of windshield time, you know, driving from Dallas to New Hampshire, that kind of thing. And people listen to the radio, they listen to audiobooks, they listen to podcasts. I know I do. So I was like, well, I could probably, you know, some of that content that I put out on the podcast is not the total beginner level stuff. It's stuff that, you know, adjusters, you know, who've done claims before might enjoy listening to. So I can't say it's a loss leader, because it takes 5 seconds to, like, you know, export a MP3 and upload it to Buzzsprout. But it has a lot of listeners. So it's grown probably more than I expected it to. And it's something that I kind of, you know, I know it kind of goes against the rules, at least as far as like being a content creator. It's a little bit intermittent. So I might do 1 to 3 or 4 episodes a month, just whenever they go out, instead of like on YouTube, it's, you know, like clockwork every week. But yeah, that's the podcast is, you know, I don't have the bandwidth for it, but I'm like, what if I just did like audio only, just turn the camera off and just come in here in my PJs and just like do audio only for the podcast listeners. But I haven't done it yet, because I don't want to lock myself into that.
And if I'm not mistaken, you do commercials for Adjuster TV Plus in the podcast, is that right? And
I do. Yes. Yeah. That's a great question. So it used to be that whatever went on YouTube, because I didn't have Uscreen. And then I started to decide one of my revenue models was going to be sponsors, which worked out really, really well. But the only problem was is that I had to, it required me to have like a salesperson that I was paying a commission to go out and get those sponsorships. But I don't do those sponsorship things anymore. My YouTube channel is for promoting my business, for promoting my platform, promoting Adjuster TV Plus, any launches that I'm doing. And so that's how that directs the kind of content that goes into YouTube. It's gonna be, that very, very wide top of funnel stuff that's real general, like, you know, six figures without a college degree, which is what we do, right? Down to like, you know, a little bit more, people have awareness already, but now they want a little bit more information. It's the funnel is, is to get them to where they can become a part of, I help them decide, I'm straight up honest, you know, this isn't for everybody. If you're in, you're in. Let's help you do this. You can do it. It's not rocket science. We're not putting satellites in orbit. And that directs what's goes on YouTube. And then obviously the Adjuster TV Plus stuff is how to the more highly produced stuff, the stuff where I like, mm-hmm. you know, get my crew together and we all go to Arizona to shoot, for 2 weeks and mm-hmm. shoot a bunch of content, a bunch of how-to content with a couple of videographers and good audio and, you know, a lot of planning and everything, which is what I really enjoy doing.
If you could pinpoint the one thing that's been the most impactful in terms of your marketing over the last 3 years, what would it be?
Honestly, I think that the number one thing that has had the biggest impact all my marketing has been consistently uploading content to YouTube. So content marketing, like that's the foundation of the whole thing. If I stop showing up, I'm not gonna try it, but so I'm just gonna assume that if I stop showing up, it's gonna have a detrimental effect. But always being there, always having a new piece of content, I think that's the number one thing. Because so many people find me through the older videos and then they see, he had a video from one day ago. You know, and since, like sometimes you go to YouTube channels and it's like the last video was 2 years ago, and you're like, are they still doing it? I mean, maybe I'll just watch somebody else's video. So I think the content marketing, consistent content marketing overall has been the number one thing.
The Adjuster TV Plus website has a number of specialized landing pages. Can you talk a little bit about what you feel goes into creating like a compelling landing page for what you're doing?
Yeah, so compelling landing pages in general they're gonna articulate that pain point immediately. When somebody goes there because they're looking for the medicine, right? Well, here's the answer. So, I think being super duper concise with messaging, being direct, you know, there's you can say, well, you know, we do this, that, and the other thing. We're socially conscious. We're this or that. Whatever it is. That's great for a company ethos, but for an effective landing page to get people to, you know, opt in or buy now, they have to look at that. They can't be looking. As soon as I start scrolling, I feel like I lose people. The very, very, that hero section on the top of a landing page has got to say, here's the answer to your problem. This will help fix it.
I love that.
Concise messaging for sure.